Hey everyone, thank you for watching. Today I'm going to be showing you how to do a progress bar in iMovie so that it's one of those that goes right across the bottom of the screen. So if you're someone who's maybe doing meditation or fitness or something where you have a countdown, or if you want to have an on-screen animation for going into the next subject, so people kind of know like chapters in a video, this is going to be the video for you. Welcome to Shelly Saves the Day. On my channel, we do YouTube Explained Simply and video editing made easy. If that sounds good to you, hit that like and subscribe, all the things. And if you're interested in actually learning how to edit with iMovie, I will be releasing my e-course soon, which is iMovie Made Easy, showing you all the ins and outs and teaching you from beginning to end to edit an entire project. I hope you're excited for that. Let's go ahead and jump into the computer and I'll show you how to do a progress bar. All right, so the first thing we have to do is we're going to have to find a clip. Okay, so we have loaded up this file here that has a motion background. Doesn't really matter what it is. It's about 34 seconds long, so we're just gonna go ahead and pick something. I'm gonna go ahead and select these stars as an overlay. You could, of course, make your own. You're gonna make it the length of your clip. Then you're gonna make sure that when you click onto it, that you go up to the video overlay settings. Then we're gonna make sure that this is going to be a picture-in-picture. Also, when that happens, you want to make sure that you take off the dissolve. You can either do that by grabbing these little arrows or putting zero for the dissolve up here. So the first thing that we have to do is we're going to make sure that this overlay is going to be the size, or at least the width, of the screen that you're working with. Then we're just going to move it down. There we go. And this is going to be how tall and thick your progress bar is going to be. So once you feel like you have it kind of where you want it, then we're gonna take this and go all the way to the very beginning frame basically. And then we are going to slide this over so that it's at the very beginning of the frame. We're going to press this little diamond, which is going to activate the keyframing. You can also hit Command K, usually for a keyboard shortcut. So we're going to have this keyframe here. Then we're going to take our playhead and we're going to go all the way to the very end position. So basically right at this end here, right? Still make sure your clip is highlighted. That way you can go in back to your overlay settings. We're going to slide this all the way out here to the end. And then when you play this back, you should see that your video is going to play and the progress bar is going to make its way over to the other side. Now, this could work in either direction. You can make your time and progress bar go either way. You could also do little things if you wanted to create a separate overlay graphic inside of like Keynote or PicMonkey or something like that. You could certainly do that. So if you wanted to say that you're talking about certain items within a video, you know, and have it stop each time you introduce a new subject, you could do that. Now you can see at the very end, it's going to hit that end, and that's exactly what you want. This could be very helpful also for people who are like in the fitness niche and want to do something like this as like a countdown clock. So you could do this as well as put up numbers on the screen for how many reps or how much time, you know, for another exercise. But I thought this would be a really easy, helpful tutorial for you.
So I hope that tutorial was easy enough to follow. Make sure if you like this video to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Would love to have you be part of the online fam. And speaking of that, we have launched channel memberships recently. So if you want to get even more out of this channel, make sure you check the down bar for details on that. And there's a separate video on my channel explaining what that all entails and means. So I hope this tutorial was helpful. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.